Darling.
Please, don't darling me, Dad. Not now.
But...
Please!
I honestly don't see what the problem is, other than you being a little embarrassed.
Me? You're the one who's doing that thing you were doing.
I was dancing.
Oh, you were not dancing. You were stripping. That was stripping.
Stripping is a form of dancing.
Roxanne?
Okay, okay. I wasn't stripping.
You weren't?
No. I was just performing an innocent lap dance for your father.
Oh, my God.
We're adults, Sarah, not teenagers. We don't have to sneak around behind your back.
That's right. And you weren't supposed to be home until 3.
Roxanne, you knew I was concerned about this. I specifically asked you not to get involved with him.
You what?
I tried to resist him. I really did. But he was relentless. Weren't you, Sailor?
Oh. Hey, hey, hey! There happens to be a much bigger picture here that you are not seeing.
What's that?
Well, Dad, you're 79 years old.
Oh, come on.
I'm serious. Dad, up until a few weeks ago, you could barely get up out of bed, which is why I'm in charge of your care now, remember?
That was the old me. I'm new and improved now.
Yes, and aren't you just a little bit curious where this mysterious burst of energy has come from?
No.
No, not even a little bit.
No, it doesn't matter. I just want to enjoy it while I got it.
But, Dad, it does matter. I mean, they didn't give you a new body. They didn't cure you of your arrhythmia, your high blood pressure, your arthritis.
They?
Who's they?
Look, Dad, I'm worried that you're going to push yourself further than your heart will allow, so I don't want you getting yourself worked up.
You're the one who's getting worked up.
No, I don't mean upset. I mean... excited. Physically speaking.
You don't want me to exercise?
Not in an intimate manner.
What is she talking about?
I don't want you having sex! Dad, it's too dangerous. Especially with a woman who's so...
Who's what?
She's so much younger than you are.
Go on.
No. This conversation is over. Come on, baby. I'll walk you home.
Dad, look, I'm only saying this for your own good.
Not that it's any of your business, but we're not even having sex.
Oh. Oh, God, I'm glad to hear that. I think it's the right choice.
Right.
Hello, Cameron.
Hi, Mrs. Carson.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi.
Are they a couple now?
No. How was school?
Fine. They were holding hands.
They're just good friends. Come on, give me a kiss. What's wrong?
Aren't I getting a little old for that?
What do you mean?
I'm a teenager now, Mom.
Yeah, so what? Teenagers don't kiss their mothers?
Not three times a day.
What brought this on?
Nothing. I just think maybe it's time we put an end to it.
Are you breaking up with me?
Mom.
I can't believe you don't want to kiss me anymore.
I didn't say that.
Yes, you did. You just said you wanted to put an end to it.
All right, can we just cut back a bit then?
Cut it back? To what?
I don't know. Like special occasions? How about Christmas and birthdays?
Three times a year.
And Mother's Day.
Oh, wow, wow. Thank God for Mother's Day.
All right. How about once a month, then?
I could maybe settle for once a day. You have to kiss me back. And you have to mean it.
All right, fine.
Where are you going?
To the store.
With the older woman?
What?
Oh, your father told me all about her. The girl at school who's older than you are?
Oh. Yeah.
I bet you let her kiss you.
The right choice. She actually thinks I'd choose not to make love to you.
Well, you're just out of practice, that's all. We just have to keep trying.
What's there to practice? It seems pretty straightforward if you ask me.
If only.
What?
Never mind. George, you have to stop worrying. This is not the end of the world.
Don't talk to me about the end of the world. I'm 79. I'm an expert in the field.
Don't be silly.
I just don't understand it. My engine is revving like mad, but I can't get the bloody thing into gear.
Maybe we need to get that pill.
What pill?
You haven't heard about it?
Well, Sarah's in charge of all the pills. I just swallow them.
Well, apparently, you just take one and presto.
Presto?
Lift off.
What are you doing here?
Nothing. What are you doing here?
Nothing.
I'm sorry, sir, but as I said, this is not an over-the-counter drug. It's a prescription drug. That means you're going to have to visit your doctor and get him to prescribe it for you.
You're a doctor, aren't you? Can't you prescribe it for me?
I'm a pharmacist, not a physician. I'm sorry. You'll have to see your doctor.
But he won't go for it. My daughter's got him under her thumb, and she'd rather I die of boredom than have a single moment of pleasure.
And it's not like we're looking for a lifetime supply here. Can't you just give us one pill?
One pill.
Just to try out.
What would be so hard about that? What?
It's okay.
I'm sorry I can't help you. Now, if you don't mind, I have customers who are waiting.
Waiting? They don't know the meaning of the word. Because I can't. It's my blood. It won't flow to the place I need it to flow.
Dad, please.
You think this is easy for me?
Look, Dad, we already talked about this, okay? It's your heart. It's too dangerous.
What is it with you and my heart? My heart is not the problem area. Now, I just need that doctor of yours to get me some of these pills.
I'm sorry, Dad. It's too much we don't know about your condition.
My condition? I'll tell you what my condition is. My condition is desperate. Is this how it's supposed to go? I fight in the war to protect my country, then work my tail off for 45 years to support my family, only to end up in my daughter's house begging her to have sex?
Dad!
What?
That's not what you meant!
I'm well enough to take care of myself. I want my own doctor, and I want my power of attorney back.
Dad, I don't think that's a good idea. Not until we know where all this is leading to.
What? I have to marry her first? My God, what's this world coming to?
I'm not talking about your relationship with Roxanne.
Oh, come on. That's what this is all about. You're uncomfortable seeing me with another woman.
What?
I'm talking about your mother.
I know.
Don't you think she'd want me to move on and make the most of what's left of my life? And don't lie. Tell the truth for once.
Okay, Dad. You want the truth?
Yes.
Dad, the reason why I'm so concerned about you is... you were abducted by aliens. Dad, they did something to you. They altered you. That's why you feel different, and that's why you can't control your urge to have sex. And that's why I don't want to take any chances, because despite what they've done to you, Dad, you're still very frail, and I'm just afraid, Dad. I'm afraid of losing you.
Aliens.
Yeah. Dad.
Why is it so hard for you to be honest with me? Do you really think I'm that far gone?
No, Dad. I am telling you the truth.
You want some, George?
No, thanks.
Want a little more croissant? Dad?
No.
What sauce is that there?
That's a barbecue.
Thank you.
What I really need to do is practice my parallel parking. And once I have that down, I'll pass for sure. And then I'll have my driver's license.
I still think 16 is far too young to be driving.
You're so uptight.
I am not.
You just don't want to face the fact that I'm an adult now. And that driving is one less way you're going to be able to control me.
It's not true. All I was getting at is that when I was your age, I wasn't allowed to start driving until I was 19. Isn't that right, Dad?
Why do you even bother asking me? You've already made up your mind.
So, Belle, you need some help with your parallel parking?
Uh-huh.
Well, if you've finished your homework, I could... take you out tonight.
Okay.
She's not allowed to drive after dark.
Mom!
What? It says right on the learner's permit, no driving after dark.
Yeah, but it doesn't say anything about parking after dark, does it? That's all I'm going to be doing. Parallel parking.
All right. Just stay as close to the driveway as you can, okay?
No problem.
Excuse me, but she can practice driving after dark.
Parking.
Why can't I go over to my friend's house?
Your friend's house, please.
So she's a girl. Big deal.
So she's your girl friend. What's her name, anyway?
When are we going to meet her?
I'm just going over there to study.
Oh, that sounds, sounds pretty good. What do you say, honey?
All right. Just be home by 9:30, okay?
No problem. Thanks, Mom.
Everybody gets to break the rules except me. Everybody gets to parallel park except me.
Parallel park? What's he talking about?
Vice Admiralty courtroom here.
George, I have a surprise for you.
I don't know if this is such a good time, baby. I'm really in a mood.
Are you ready?
As ready as I'll ever be.
Oh, I wouldn't bet on that.
Tony, you should know that we
turn it off. 100 models and miniatures of different vessels. Do you know what this is?
It isn't what I think it is, is it?
I think it is what you think it is.
Where did you get it?
Oh, I know a gal who knows a gal about a boyfriend who doesn't need them anymore.
His problem just went away on its own?
You could say that. He's dead.
Oh.
Avalanche.
Oh.
What do you say we take one of these bad boys on a test drive?
Lead the way.
Good morning.
Now, we chip in today.
Hey, buddy. How'd it go last night?
We just studied.
Okay.
He's not there.
What do you mean?
I mean, I couldn't find him. He's not in his room.
Isabel? Did his bed look slept in?
I don't know. Didn't really look made. What does that have to do? Oh.
You don't think,
I don't know. What?
Good morning.
Ted, where have you been?
Good morning, gentlemen.
Please tell me that's not what I think it is.
Oh, it is.
Oh my God, Dad, what have you done? Isabel, Cameron, off to school now.
I don't know, Mom. This is pretty damn educational.
This is not funny.
What?
Dad, what have you done?
I don't think you want to hear the gory details, dear, but suffice it to say, I didn't get any sleep last night, and I've never felt more refreshed. I could leap over this house if I wanted.
Don't you mean pole vault?
You took one of those pills!
No, Sarah. It was the aliens. They took me away in their spaceship, and the next thing I know...
That is not funny!
But it's the truth.
Dad, you took one of those pills.
What if I did?
I told you not to.
Tough. It's my life. Why shouldn't I be able to make my own choices?
Because, Dad, you're not responsible enough. I mean, look at the state you're in, for God's sake.
I'm alive, aren't I? No heart problems here.
I'm not talking about your heart.
What then?
Dad!
It's perfectly natural for men to have this happen in the morning. It lets us know the equipment is still working. I'm really surprised you don't know that.
It is not perfectly natural, and I do not want it in the house with the children around.
Oh, don't worry. It'll start going down soon enough.
Well, Dad, what if it doesn't?
Darling, I'm not that virile.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Well, I have to be honest with you. We've never seen anything like this before.
You flatter me, ma'am.
Dad? Do you mean that it might be permanently... permanent?
No, we can take care of that. What I mean is I can't find any reason why you would have this kind of reaction to the medication in the first place.
Well, he shouldn't have been taking it in the first place, right? I mean,
at his age, with his arrhythmia and high blood pressure?
Actually, those issues are not factors that would prevent him from getting a prescription.
Why don't you tell her about the aliens, dear?
Not now.
I'm sorry, aliens?
Oh, it's nothing.
George? George. Oh, my baby. Look at you. How are you feeling?
I'm fine. Everything's going to be okay.
So, what's the story?
Well, first of all, we need to mitigate the erection. Then you're going to have to make a choice. You can try taking the medication again at a lower dose
and risk this happening again, which could very well lead to permanent tissue damage. Or you can avoid sexual intercourse altogether.
No. It's up to you. You decide.
What do you think, baby? Can we find other ways to amuse ourselves?
Of course we can. We'll just have to use our imagination, that's all.
You do have a hell of an imagination.
Okay. You're going to feel a little... well, you know what I mean.
Yep.
I squeeze my hand.
Here we go.
Oh!
What they did to me, what they did it with. I've never felt so violated in my whole life.